in the Illinois State Lottery's daily game and pick four. Tonight's drawing is supervised by Marv Gordon, partner with the accounting firm of Labenthal and Horwath. These are tonight's three daily game machines in a randomly selected order. Each has 10 balls, 0 through 9. Drawing starts by mixing the balls in the first machine. Next, the balls in the second machine, and then the third machine. Now, here is tonight's first winning daily game digit. 7. Tonight's second winning digit is 0. And the third and last digit is 7. So for tonight, the official daily game winning number is 707. Now the pick four machines in a randomly selected order. The balls are mixed in the first machine, then the second machine, then the third machine, and finally the fourth machine. Now the first winning digit for pick four. 8. The second number. 4. The third number. 3. And the fourth and last digit is 3. So for tonight, the official pick four number is 8433. Join us again tomorrow night for the daily game and the pick four drawing, and this Saturday for Lotto for an estimated grand prize of $6 million to a single winner.
It's been 20 years since the Beatles took over America. Tonight on PM Magazine, celebrate at a Beatles convention with everything from Beatle record players to real live lookalikes.
Then, it's been 30 years since these classic Chevys and Caddies cruised the strip to the local drive-in. Hop in to visit an East Coast mecca for 50s car buffs.
And this is a sport for the 80s, as beachside volleyball isn't just a picnic game anymore. It's gone major league. See how these California champs have turned it into a world-class sport.
This fort protected the settlers during the Blackhawk Indian War in 1832, and it's part of the Naperville settlement in Naperville, Illinois. And we intend to take you for a look around tonight on PM Magazine. I'm Susan Boller.
And I'm Dave Saint. Naperville settlement is a great way to explore the pioneer heritage and to see how our early settlers lived in northern Illinois. But our first story tonight is strictly 1980s all the way. Imagine spending all day at the beach playing volleyball and getting paid for it to boot.
Now the question is, who would pay somebody to play beach volleyball? Well, apparently a lot of people, if you're good. It's now considered a pro sport, commanding up to $200,000 in prize money just last year. Now let's go to Manhattan Beach in California to catch some of the action.
This is the most successful beach sport in the country, pro beach volleyball. High-powered, fiercely competitive, and it's played by sun-bronzed beach boys, not beach bums. These guys are professional athletes. Tournament spectators number in the thousands, and top players are sponsored by giant corporations. No longer just a Sunday afternoon workout. California's volleyball has gone major league.
People, you know, used to think of a picnic sport, but no, it's not a picnic sport. There's very talented athletes out here diving, running in the sand for hours at a time, the fatigue. The ball is going over 100 miles an hour, people making spectacular plays. There's a lot of athletic ability out here, and it's just starting to be appreciated.
Tim Hovland is one of a dozen world-class players who live in the heart of volleyball country, Manhattan Beach. He and his partner, Mike Dodd, are the 1983 world champions. Unlike many of the other players who support their volleyball with part-time jobs, Tim and Mike are full-time professionals. During the winter, they play in Italy, but their summers are spent on the pro beach circuit.
You know, it's a very healthy atmosphere to play in, nice office to work at. It's not like you're gonna go inside a gymnasium and sit out there and sweat. It's very pleasing.
Right Right now, volleyball is all that matters to Tim Hovland. Home is where he can wake up to the sounds of a pounding surf and never be too far from a volleyball net. His routine is disciplined. Get up, work out, play volleyball. A lifestyle any athlete would envy.
I wouldn't say this is we're beach bums at all. We're professional businessmen. We're down here to do this as a living. We work very hard at what we're doing. We're very professional about how we do it.
The biggest beach parties in California are the Pro Beach Volleyball Tournaments. What was once seen by a handful of people now draws more than 20,000 spectators. It's the California lifestyle on parade, and the Volley Dollies are a part of the fringe benefits.
You know, you have the good-looking guy volleyball players out there diving and running through the sand, and you have just beautiful women that come out and watch these things. It's, you know, it's very distracting as to play also, but it's the whole scene.
At the 1983 World Championships, the team of Hovland and Dodd was devastating. Tournaments are a grueling two-day elimination process that become more a test of endurance than anything else. In the end, only the strongest players survive.
It takes a lot of dedication, a lot of experience. You gotta love what you're doing and be willing to put a lot of time and effort into it.
World-class opponents are never far away from Tim and Mike. In fact, most of the players who compete in the tournaments practice together regularly. Randy Stoklos and St. John Smith are the 1982 world champions who continue to threaten Hovland and Dodd. Both do part-time work as actors and models, but when they get out on the court, it's all volleyball.
I feel the best combination is to have a partner of equal ability. Having Mike block sometimes, I block sometimes. We mix it up, we share the load equally.
Get it, Mike.
You know, I think we're two equal players, and that makes a good balance.
Another victory for Hovland and Dodd, but this one goes unheralded.
Thanks,
both teams got the workout they wanted, and the only thing left is to head for the showers, or in this case, the ocean. Pro beach volleyball is so physically taxing, most of these players will be burned out by the age of 30. But until then, they get to live the kind of lifestyle that's the envy of all the world.
A lot of other people like to be inside and work hard with their the motor skills, but I like to be outside and be physical and stay in shape and work hard at a good sport.
Now, if you think your life is tough compared to a professional volleyball player, imagine what life was like for the original settlers here in Naperville. They had to build Fort Payne here just to fend off Indian attacks in the 1830s. They only had one casualty here, but it goes to show that they were prepared for just about anything. Coming up next, we'll take a trip back into the more recent past and remember 1964 and see how Beatlemania lives on today.
Bring home the bacon from Dominick's. This week, old-fashioned country-style sliced bacon is just 89 cents a pound through Wednesday at Dominick's.
Big selection, Shoetown. You'll find big fashion, Shoetown. You'll get big savings, up to 60%. Big, 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 big in shoes at Shoetown.
Only Benelin has it. Robitussin doesn't. Triaminic doesn't. Neither does any other cough medication. Only Benelin contains diphenhydramine, the exclusive cough suppressant introduced by doctors to over 30 million people. Benelin, same full strength available today without prescription to relieve your cough hour after hour. Benelin from Park Davis, helping your pharmacist and your doctor help your health.
At first glance, all airlines may appear to be the same, but one gives you a special way to fly. An airline so large it carries over 30 million people a year, yet so personalized you can reserve your seat a year in advance.
We have the seat you want, Mr. Martin.
In a world of airlines, one airline, American Airlines, can make your trip something special.
Welcome aboard.
Something special in the air.
Now, every wallpaper's half price at Saxon.
The best papers and the best books in stock and all half price.
Every paper, half price at Saxon.
This is the way clothes were made back in the 1830s, and here at the Naper settlement, they still do things the old way. The wool is spun into thread, and the thread is woven into cloth. This is a shawl that was made right here at the settlement. It is just gorgeous. Well, our next story takes us back a few years, but only about 20, when the Beatles, the Fab Four, were the hottest group around. Tonight, PM Magazine's Liz Miles takes us to a Beatlemania convention in Pittsburgh, where the only difference she found between yesterday and today is the cost of memorabilia.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something, I think you'll understand.
20 years ago, the legend began. On February 9th, 1964, four young men from England shook the world and gave us a new meaning for the term rock music. The group, of course, was the Beatles. Beatlemania conventions, like this one held in Pittsburgh recently, are popular worldwide. Every kind of Beatle memorabilia is on display here, from $95 Fab Four lunch boxes to an $800 bobbing head display.
It came out for the Meet the Beatles album, and they had it in record stores, and I found it in an old record shop, a man who didn't realize the value of it, and I kind of begged him for it, and he kind of let me have it.
This is a German pressing of the very first Beatles single, and it's before they were called the Beatles. They're Tony Sheridan and the Beat Brothers. It sells for $200.
One of the rarest items in the show is this controversial Butcher album.
Well, the album was originally released by Capitol with this cover. It was out for about a week. Some copies were sold. Then Capitol recalled it, and it came out in this cover. And the value of the album in stereo, this condition, roughly $200 to $400. The mono is about two. I also have this drum from England, which is 1964. It was a toy drum sold there. It's also valued around $300 to $400.
Did you know that Ringo Starr's first boy, Zach, was born on September the 13th? Did you know that Paul McCartney's last boy, James Lewis, was born on September the 13th?
If you want a more reasonably priced souvenir, you can find it at this man's booth. He is 74-year-old Tony Sachs, who claims to be the oldest Beatlemaniac. Tony's prized possession is this Rickenbacker guitar, autographed in gold by all four Beatles. For $3 a shot, Tony will take a picture of you holding it.
When the Beatles performed here in Pittsburgh at the Civic Arena back in 1964, tickets went on sale for $5.95. They opened the concert with Twist and Shout, and the entire show only lasted 45 minutes. But despite the fact that it was over all too soon for most people, it was still the chance of a lifetime. And for some, it was an experience that produced memories that are still very much alive today.
The Beatles, for me, were really the epitome of fun and excitement. I think they were filling the place at that point of the boyfriends I was not yet to have, and they really were zaniness and just a chance to really enjoy a teenage life.
20 years ago, Janet Carr was a true Beatlemaniac. She has preserved all her memories in this scrapbook and keeps it updated even today.
Oh, I would never throw it out. It's the most valuable thing I have. I think if I were going to write my will, I'd have to make sure that it was in my will. It's very valuable to me. I put a lot of time into it, and it really, for me, captures one of the most fun parts of my life.
There's no doubt that the Beatle phenomenon is a crowd pleaser. This look-alike band, called 1964, is a group that captures the excitement of the early Beatle era.
One, two, three, four!
It's unique in the sense that we're doing a tribute to what we experienced.
I think people remember the Beatles through Beatle groups and conventions like this, as long as people have memories, you know.
I need a place to hide away.
The Beatles are certainly a group that will never be forgotten. They gave us memories of yesterday that still bring happiness today.
The Beatles yesterday, Michael Jackson today. Who will be the stars of tomorrow? Well, Ben Vereen knows.
That's right. He's working with young singers, dancers, and actors all the time. And starting next week, he's going to introduce them to us as part of our new star series.
That's right. We'll have five different stars all bringing us their favorite stories. In addition to Ben Vereen, we'll have Sally Struthers. We'll also have Loretta Swit, Bill Rafferty, and Robbie Benson will be on the lineup, too.
It's going to be just great, and we'll tell you more about it tomorrow. But coming up next, he turns photographs into masterpieces. Find out how when we come back.
It's an ordinary day, but soon that's going to change, because this is no ordinary biscuit. This is Hungry Jack. Notice how tall it is and how delicately it flakes to the touch. Now, break it open to layers and layers of that hot, butter-melting Hungry Jack tenderness. Now, eat it. Savor it. Enjoy it. This is no ordinary day. This is a Hungry Jack day.
You could use one kind of paint if all your painting needs were the same, but different surfaces, indoors and out, need different kinds of protection. Hi, Pat Summerall. That's why True Value Hardware Stores manufacture their own complete line of TruTest paints and stains. And they make it easy for you to choose the right finishes for your lifestyle and budget with three grades: economical TruTest Special, popular TruTest Select, and premium TruTest Supreme, exclusively from participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
The weather sure is nice, but pretty soon winter will be here with wind, rain, and snow. Wouldn't it be nice to have a new front-wheel drive Ford Tempo to handle all that weather? You can save up to $653 on this Ford Tempo and get AM/FM stereo, 5-speed manual transmission, steel-belted radials, and more. So what are you waiting for? See your Ford dealer today.
It began in Greenwich, England. Three courageous men set out to circumnavigate the globe, crossing both the North and South Poles in their travels. A blistering expedition that would carry them 52,000 miles to the ends of the earth. A breathtaking adventure of man's unquenchable desire to achieve the impossible. Richard Burton hosts this true life drama of heroic achievement, To the Ends of the Earth.
Tonight at 8 on Metro Media 32.
Welcome back. I'm with Harold, who is the official printer here at the Naper Settlement Print Shop, and he tells me they have an authentic 1890 printer behind me. It still works. By the way, every year the Naperville Heritage Society sponsors a very special antique show and sale, and this year's will be happening this weekend at North Central College, and all the proceeds benefit the Naper Settlement to keep their buildings in top-notch condition. To be a top-notch photographer takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, experience, and a good teacher like Dwayne Sorrow. He's considered one of the best in the country. He's turned photography into an art.
A painting that endures the test of time is a true masterpiece. To capture life's beauty is a rare gift, and Dwayne Sorrow has that talent, only with a photograph. He's a skilled photographer who applies oil paint to his photos to create incredible works of art. His astounding talent has earned him a great deal of respect and money.
One of the things that would be difficult is that we're working with such a broad pattern of line, a reflector would not be able to be brought in close enough to do an adequate job. In terms of lighting on her face, it can be approached, like I had mentioned before, with a strobe light.
His feeling, his sensitivity, and his total artistic ability are just phenomenal.
He's just brilliant. The photographs that he does are a cross between Rembrandt and Norman Rockwell.
These comments are not coming from amateurs. These are some of the top photographers in the country, and they've gathered in Michigan to learn his techniques.
The first thing that I say is that if they're coming to the program looking for a formula or an easy tip of that nature, then it isn't really available. It isn't certainly something that I have, that there is a sensitivity that I think most people are capable of.
He tries to show other photographers how to use their emotions along with their expertise to create not just a picture, but a work of art.
I try not to be a scientist when I'm taking pictures. It gets in my way. Look right at the camera, Michelle. So I'm going to put this light in more by feel. It's intuitive. Just look at her face and look at her body.
The basic message is to make your subject look just right and then position yourself so the background is equally pleasing. This is a good tip for anyone who likes to snap pictures of their family and friends.
The other thing as she turns the head is it's going to become more provocative. As I bring this further out to the edge and let the fingers drape, the hand is becoming much more graceful.
Once the body is in place, Duane feels it's just as important to make sure the surroundings are right.
You see, it's bad because that vertical pillar is directly touching her head.
And when Duane feels everything is just right, he takes a picture. But what develops is not the finished product. This is when it all comes together for Duane. He now combines his talent in photography with the artistry of the old masters by applying oil paint directly to the picture.
The other time that I would put oil paint on a photograph is if I wanted to not only control dark and light areas, but if I wanted to tint the entire photograph and create a more lyrical effect to it.
Imagine trying to apply oil paint to your favorite photo. It's a tricky procedure, but Duane feels his work of art is not complete unless he does everything possible to make it picture perfect. That means spending 10 or more hours on a single photo. This kind of dedication earns Duane high praise from his fellow professionals. Helen Yancey, an award-winning photographer who does artwork on photos for the Eastman Kodak Corporation, has instructed all over the world. But today, she has come to learn.
He's one of the finest artists in our business, and I stress the word artist. We have a lot of photographers and a few that are photographers and artists, and I'm very, very impressed with his work.
And this is it, the essence of his talent. He's taken a nice photo, cut out the unnecessary background, deepened the color tones with oil paint, added a few of his own special touches, and created another work of art. For Duane Sorrow, this is what makes his work as a photographer so fascinating. For the rest of us, it's what makes his work so beautiful to view. We're fortunate just to be able to say that we have seen a Sorrow.
Next, it's a return to the real happy days, cruising 50 style.
At Dominick's Fresh Produce at Big Savings is our specialty year-round. This week, save on golden ripe bananas, just 18 cents a pound through Wednesday at Dominick's.
I'm Alex Tapper, president of First City Builders. I like to set the record straight about remodeling prices. At First City Builders, we guarantee to meet or beat any remodeling bid or give you the difference in cash, and you never sacrifice quality. First City means first quality. Call us for a free, no-obligation estimate on aluminum or stone siding, porches, dormers, room additions, kitchens, baths, recreation rooms, any work, big or small. Just call First City at 583-8922, 583-8922.
Here's the place so many women are talking about, the famous Burlington Coat Factory, where you can actually see coats and sportswear being made for fine stores everywhere. And here's one of Burlington's warehouses, where you can see these and other famous brand coats, the largest selection in the country, plus famous designer sportswear, children's clothing, and menswear, all the better labels, all at fabulous savings. The Burlington Coat Factory, a great place to save on the fashions you want.
Paying bills?
As always.
If you own your home, Diamond Financial Services can help you cut the bills down to size.
I don't want a second mortgage.
No, we'll write a new first mortgage. You'll get the cash you need and have only one monthly payment that's less than you're paying out now.
Cash to pay these off?
Sure, and you might have some left over.
Diamond, you're a gem.
Call today. See how Diamond can help you get the most out of life.
The
This is the Murray House, built back in 1842, and you won't find a microwave around this kitchen. This is cooking done the hard way, but the only way the settlers knew how. And this is Mary, who's baking up some good old-fashioned oatmeal cookies, and they sure smell good. Can I steal one later?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Well, now we're going to take you to another place that brings us back to the happy days of the 1950s. It's the Sycamore Inn, and everything from the burgers to the shakes is just the way you remember.
At the Sycamore Drive-In Restaurant in Bethel, Connecticut, nothing much has changed since its doors opened in 1949. Current owner, Rich Melvin, who bought the place 7 years ago, still grinds fresh hamburger every day. His wife, Lucy, works the counters. The root beer is made by using an old family recipe. And of course, there's curb service.
Hi, can I help you?
All of these factors make the restaurant a pretty unique place in this modern world of mass-produced fast food. And that's exactly what makes it the perfect location for a hopping Saturday night when you're cruising 50 style. It all started 3 years ago when car buff Dino Lawrence and his partner Dave Dufresne approached Rich with an idea. If he would allow them to use the Sycamore, they would take care of all the details of promoting the successful Saturday night extravaganza. Saturday night at the Sycamore has become an East Coast mecca for 50s car nostalgia. Hundreds of people drive hundreds of miles with plenty of good reasons for being there.
I always loved the 50s, and I grew up in the 50s, and it's just a flashback of what things used to be, nice and calm.
Well, you don't see these cars every day, and it's just an education just coming here and looking at the cars and seeing, wow, that, you know, was like it was back then.
'57 Chevy Bel Air. All right.
Who needs a vanilla shake to go?
Give me 12 burgers to go.
12 burgers to go with fried onions.
Well, it's really great here. It's nice to just be here with everybody. It's really nice cars, and I was really surprised to see all the cars lined up in four different places.
You'll see things here that you'll never see anywhere else. Very special cars, a lot of hand craftsmanship, and the Russians sure as hell aren't doing it.
You're a loser if you're not a cruiser.
It's just something you have to be here to experience it, and I think it's more like an art form.
500 hamburgers, 75 gallons of root beer, and 6 hours later, the cruise night comes to a close. A parade of lead sleds and custom cars makes its way back home and back into the 80s. But when next Saturday rolls around, so will the 50s, when Cruisin' Night at the Sycamore returns.
That looked like a lot of fun. We certainly have had our fill of nostalgia on PM Magazine tonight. Let's look at what we're going to see tomorrow night.
You'll want to be with us when Ron Smith comes to town to add to his stable of celebrity and political lookalikes.
Not only that, we'll preview the new Arnold Schwarzenegger film. And if you'd like to come out here to the Naper Settlement, it is open to the public year-round for tour groups. But if you're coming as an individual, it'll close the first week in November.
And finally, we've come into the Century Memorial Chapel. Even though it was built back in 1864, there are still weddings held here today. And the old pump organ still works, and Al, the house organist, is going to show us how well. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Harry, tell me, how good a deal did the gallant men really give you?
Oh,
what does that mean? How good a deal was it?
Oh.
Come on, it couldn't have been that good.
Oh,
Harry, you're killing me.
If you want to know who puts the O in something to crow about, see the great deals in the 1985 Oldsmobiles at
the Gallant Men of Olds.
Oh, did Harry get a deal?
I'm here at the Burlington Coast.